Welcome, and thank you for watching this video tutorial. In it, we will explain the basics of what session data is, how it works, and what you can do with it. Session data is basically a copy of the last known state of your instrument. Important to know is that you will only get session data if your data model has a primary key. Once you have that, the system will save all kinds of data in a session database without the need to do anything else. Session data allows you to interrupt an interview and get back to it at a later point in time and continue where you left off. This is possible because the session database not only saves on-route responses like the BDBX, but also any off-route responses that may have been given, aux fields, and information about the state of the survey, like active field, page, parallel, and language. It does, however, need server contact to save what's on each page. As a result, it is possible that you will lose the information from the last page you were on if the interview was not closed properly, for example, by clicking on the cross to close the browser, or if the server crashes. Everything up to the previous page will still be saved, so you will never lose a lot of information. It's usually best to provide an abort button that uses a quit action. This will close the interview properly, and because it makes server contact, no data will be lost. Note that by default, the session data is flushed from memory to the session database every 10 seconds and upon closing of the session, so there might be a slight delay in seeing the data. When you start an interview with a primary key, the session database is checked to determine whether the key is present in the database. If it exists, the session data will be loaded into the interview and it will resume where you left off. If it doesn't exist, it depends on the form access mode whether pre-filled data from the real database is loaded and a new session for this record is created in the session database. Note that if you pass a value for a field in the runtime parameters, the session data might overwrite your assignment, depending on your assign mode. By default, the session database is stored in the settings folder at the survey deployment location as specified during installation. For development, this is usually your own local machine. For production, it will be the server that you have given the session role. All session data from all installed instruments will get stored in the session database. Similar to the audit trail and the real data, you can supply a file that points to other databases like SQL Server or Oracle, if you prefer. For session data, this would be a BSDI file added in the server manager. You can also specify where the session data is stored per instrument. In this case, add the BSDI to the instrument. Aside from the session data being a backup in case of an unexpected ending of an interview, it can also be used to look at data of ongoing interviews, or to see if specific fields are getting the expected value during testing. To do this, you can use the Session Viewer, which is similar to BlazeForce Watch Window, except that it works for all data entry clients, not just in the DEP. Note that you need to run the survey in client-server run mode for this. First, you connect to a server. You select the survey you want to inspect from the list of available surveys. It will open a list with all available sessions for that instrument. Select the session you are interested in. On the left-hand side, you will see all current values. You can select which fields you want to see. Click on the Watch button or use Ctrl+W to see the results in a separate window. If anything changes in the survey, you will see this on the right-hand side when you press F5. Note that there needs to have been server contact before you see any changes. Some important settings can be found in the Session tab of the Settings tab in the Control Center. You can define when or if you want the server to time out after a period of inaction. After a timeout, the respondent will be required to re-enter the primary key, after which they will return to the place they left off. Server timeout is 20 minutes by default. save means that all en route responses in the session data will be saved to the BDBX when a checked instance occurs. You would use this if you want to pre-process incomplete data or if you want unfinished cases to be available for processing when the survey period ends. Delete determines whether or not to keep the session data in the session database after a session is interrupted. You would do this, for example, for extra security reasons. It's best to use this setting in combination with the save option. Note that when an interview has reached the end, the so-called receipt page, the en route data of the now completed survey is stored in the BDBX and the session data for this record is removed from the session database. Finally, it could be useful to know that during questionnaire development, session data from previous versions of that questionnaire can be removed as soon as it is reinstalled. Check the Clear Sessions option in File, Options, General to use this functionality. For more information, check the Help Topics Session Data, Session Settings, and Session Viewer. We hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.